Howard Stern Show.
I've gotten much better at finding the line. And I think my audiences have gotten better at giving me that slack.
Right.
You know, I remember one time I was on stage in Toronto, and it was snowing out. And it was a long show. I was up there over an hour, and I had to pee. And I've never done this before. I ran off stage to pee because I wanted to do another half hour. And I'd been flying all day, and I had to pee. So in the 2 minutes that I ran off stage, someone in the audience checked their phone, and they saw that Whitney Houston died. And as soon as I come back out, someone goes, "Whitney Houston just died." And I go, like, it just sort of hit me weird, you know, and I said, "Houston, we have a problem."
Right.
Simple joke.
Right.
If I had any time to think about it, it was not funny.
Right.
But because the guy just yelled it out, it sounded real. You heard a gasp.
Right.
People confirmed it. And I started riffing on Whitney Houston in the moment. And I thought, that's how comedians deal with pain. That's how people, you know, they've been talking a lot about this lately, like people are too sensitive and PC jokes. And Jerry Seinfeld had some interesting comments the other day that he won't perform at colleges anymore. And there's so much truth to that. People are expecting comedians, Howard, to water down what we do. But the truth is, would you want your medicine watered down? Comedy is therapeutic. The world is dark. If we start avoiding the dark issues, it's going to be depressing.
Well, not only that. You know, it reminds me, like on the radio, I don't have a net, so to speak. For 4 hours, 5 hours, I'm sitting here talking off the cuff, pretty much. And so when there's a mistake made, let's say, or maybe a too soon kind of moment, they're like, "Oh, you fucking asshole, this."
Right.
But dude, I'm just trying to entertain you here.
Right.
And I think that's the same thing what you're saying. Like, okay, do you really want to go to a club where you only do your rehearsed material? Or do I want to see Jeffrey Ross doing his material, and all of a sudden he has a spontaneous moment, comes in off the bathroom, and Whitney Houston died, and boom, and then he just starts riffing.
Right.
I'd rather see that, even if you do offend me.
Right.
It's important to me to see that. I want to
see
that.
We just had this conversation with Louis C.K. when he was hosting SNL.
Right.
He tried to talk about pedophilia.
Right. Yeah.
And it was, you know, the audience didn't know what to do.
I thought
it was brilliant stuff.
Yeah.
As a country, think about it. As a people, why would we want to tame down the comedy? Why wouldn't we be encouraging ourselves to toughen up and get thicker skin as a nation? Life sucks sometimes. It's a comedian's job to shine a light on the darkness. Otherwise, it gets ignored. We're showing the sadness of the world and trying to lighten it up a little bit.
And you can't be inhibited when you're on stage. You got to be loose, and you got to be willing to just kind of riff, and people have to give you some leeway.
It's like going to the gym. You're gonna you're gonna show my workout as a Super Bowl? No. This is what we do. And if comedians can't just start take big swings, it's going to be all going to be jugglers and stuff.
The Howard Stern Show.